Oh man. Oh. We got some flea market finds. Look at that. Double bed.
Hey, hello. Welcome back to my Joyful Obsession channel about axes and other completely non-related content. And I have a flea market find, which is in Idaho, that's really actually rare. In this part of Idaho, it's just you can't find great axes at flea markets and antique malls. But today I found two. This is one of them. That is a Marshall Wells Hardware Company handmade swamping pattern double bit axe, 4 pounds. You can see the marking there, 4 pounds. Just beautiful. Seen some days. That's all right. But it's got this beautiful handle on it, which in terms of like grain run out and all that stuff is terrible. But it's old, it's been used, and we're gonna do our best to save it. That's just really cool, right? Give it new life and make it a beautiful thing. All right, tough to kind of show this, but the main problems are with the handle, okay? I really wanna bring this back. Look, it's warped in really two ways. Bent that way, it's kind of bent all this way, right? And the stuff left in the haft. And let's get a better shot. Let's get some light on the subject. Look at all that mush. It's pretty much just kind of disintegrated. And of course that gives me concern that as I pull out that wedge and try to bring this back, is that there won't be enough left there to rehaft it. But we're gonna try, because it's just cool, right? And if all else fails, we'll get a new handle and give it new life that way.
Okay, well, decision time on the handle. We got it out. I've been looking it over, checking it out with some light, and the Marshall Wells Hardware Company of Duluth, Minnesota, from what I've been able to find out, dropped the hardware part of its name in like 1916. So this head, all right, is a nice vintage head. And it's in great shape. There's some great steel there. Definitely worth bringing back to life. But this handle was not good to begin with. It was not good to begin with. First of all, I think it was carved out of heartwood, like the center of the tree, because I can see the center of the tree and the rings right there in the knob. So not a good sign, right? And it's warped in one dimension. Pretty bad, and it's kind of warping the other. The head is pretty disintegrated. I don't know, it's got some hope. There's still some material there. Grain orientation, not good. I think just for pure science of it, we're gonna give it the full spa treatment and see what we can do. Add the axe to the work crew, take it out, hammer away at a tree or so. And see if it just blows up after all that work. It's very possible.
Nope. You know, sometimes, like, you start a relationship, you know, and the faults in the person you're with is just, they're self-evident, but you have the hope and you're gonna work it out, right? Someone's gonna change. And so I had the hope that, you know, Marshall Wells handle here, it's gonna come back. It's gonna be a nice, whippy, antique handle. There's no chance. This is too far gone. It's just a sponge in the form of a stick now. So, have to abandon that plan of complete refurbishment. So one thing I do not have in my work crew is a 36 inch double bit handle. So I got one brand new, pretty darn good, sweet, sweet hickory handle, right? And this is an amazing head for a, you know, flea market find. This is a winner. 4 pounds, that's a big double bit. So it deserves a big handle. Do some big swinging, all right? So we're gonna give it a new look and give it a new life here with a new handle. That's what we gotta do. Right, and you know, a little extra benefit, I got some Nick Thrain black walnut wedges. Very premium, very dark wood, hard. It's gonna look amazing, all right? Totally worth it, putting those in there. So this is gonna be a good project, right? We're gonna go all out.
Okay, well, it's almost as if the gods of axe restoration have blessed me in my choice. Because this beaver tooth handle, stock handle, just not that much money, fits perfectly on my 100-year-old, at least 100-year-old, Marshall Wells Hardware Company 4-pound double bit hacks. It does. It fits it perfectly. I pounded it on. I worked on it. I'll show you the technique. And I got it all the way down to almost here, just without doing anything. So it's perfectly formed for this. And now it's only the amount of obsession that I want to spend on it to get it to fit, which is amazing. I'm so happy for that. Madamina, il catalogo è questo, delle belle chiamo il padron mio, un catalogo è lì che ho fatto, osservate, leggete con me, osservate, leggete con me. In Italia 640, in Lamagna 231, 100 in Francia, in Turchia 91, ma in Spagna, ma in Spagna son già 1003, 1003, 1003. Ma fra queste contadine, camerieri cittadine, ma contesse e baronesse, marchesone, principesse, e madone, donni, cavo, donni, corpo, donni, età, donni, mi forma, donni, età. In Italia, 640, in Lavagna, 231, 100 in Francia, in Turchia, 91, ma, ma, ma. Contadine, camerieri, cittadine, ma contesse, baronesse, marchesane, principesse, e mandone, donni, claro, donni, forma, donni, età, donni, forma, donni, età, donni, forma, donni, età. Nella bionda, nella lusa,
okay, so the technique for the grip of the handle, the way I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna stain it, I'm gonna dye it and stain it. I'm gonna use this combo here that over this darker hickory is, I'm just hoping it's gonna be interesting, because when you commit, and I don't got an extra handle. So we're gonna see how it goes. Thank you.
Next day, the amber dye leaves a. It's a lot. It's a little more orange than it looks, I think, in the video. But it's really cool, and it lays down a base of color. Then we're gonna add the shaker maple. See that? Shaker maple's going on next as a stain. And those two combined, we're hoping. Produces a great finish.
Leggeri di testa, non andate girando qua e là, e qua e là, e qua e là. Poco dura del mattino, festa del mattino, festa, ma per me comincia l'ora, che piacere ti sarà.
Okay, I think this is coming together really nice. I'm really liking it, right? Using the stain and the dye together, three coats of the stain, and working with the dye. I kind of think dye, it must slow down the absorption of anything you put on it, including BLO, because it takes longer to dry. It takes longer for it to bite and get in. So anyways, I had to, you know, had to experiment with getting the dye to, or the stain to work the way I wanted to, but great brown color now. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna experiment with some linseed oil paint, which is really hard to get in the United States, but is, you know, the superior paint for sure. I think if you're gonna work with axes, you know, and you're not gonna need a whole lot, so just get this little pot of it, kind of a sample size, and that'll do me right for 100 axes, I think. So, but one thing about the boiled linseed oil is they highly recommend that you put linseed oil on the surface already, and it needs to be treated. So we're gonna do a couple coats of BLO now, and all right, and get it ready and start to treat the wood. And then we're gonna apply a racing stripe and probably put on more BLO, because I love BLO. It's like the favorite thing, right? Just lather it, so nice.
Thank you.
So the Gray Book of Lore recommends for filling axes certain angles at certain points along the bit. Okay, a certain angle at the cutting edge, a certain angle about a half inch in, certain angles at the low point of the cheek, a certain angle all the way up to the eye swell. And so for grinding, it seems to me the most important guide I'm going to need is this 15 degrees at 1/2 inch from the cutting edge. Okay, a good filling axe is sharp and penetrates well. And often, your production axes are often a less conscientious job at sharpening. You won't get that angle. You just won't get there unless you know where you're going. And I'll show you why here in a second. But so what I've done, I take my angle gizmo, which has a name, but I call it the angle gizmo, and I've set it at 15 degrees, and I mark 1/2 inch. And this gives me a guide, okay, until my super fancy European angle guide shows up on where what I'm going for with the grind. Okay, and I'll show you this now.
And sure enough, we got a long ways to go. There's a long ways to go. That is nowhere close to 15 degrees at the half inch point, okay? So I need to grind metal and shape it to produce a beautiful sharp edge, but I gotta get to there, and we got a ways to go. So learned a lot, working on the backside. You saw the results. Hard work, hard work. I'm gonna go through some files in this hobby, no doubt about it. But now I've learned a lot more about how to set my guides a little more so that they'll survive and I'll tear them up so fast, which I will tear them up, but you'll get that nice radial edge and good transition that's solid. Then we'll do the rooster method. Okay, by hand, sharpen this thing to a mirror polish. And I can't wait. I cannot wait to try this out on real lumber.
Thank you.
Yeah.